Hello, Whole Foods readers. I'm Kaylin Chiarello-Eppner, editor of Whole Foods Magazine, and I'm here with author and chef Baker Dan, who recently authored the book Beating Arthritis, Alternative Cooking.
Baker Dan specializes in alternative cooking and baking, and his new book offers recipes and a plan to help readers who are dealing with inflammatory conditions like rheumatoid arthritis. Good morning, Baker Dan.
Yeah, good morning.
Let's talk about your book.
I've been afflicted with palindromic rheumatoid arthritis 18 years ago, and what I did a cleansing diet, and then I added the ingredients one by one until I got into what I call a safe list of ingredients, meaning ingredients that do not cause me inflammation. And then I made my recipes out of this safe list. And people start hearing about this method, and they started calling me. So after a few years, what I did is I said, wait a minute, just sit down and write a book. Because I realized that it takes like at least a good 1 hour to explain what I'm doing, and that there is a lot to be said. So I just sat down, and it took 4 years, and I wrote the book.
Awesome. That's very interesting. I love the idea of a safe list. So it seems that certain vegetables and staples throughout your recipes appeared again and again, like zucchini and cauliflower. Was that part of your safe list? Why did you emphasize these ingredients?
What happened, you picked up a very important point, because as you said, these ingredients are part of my personal safe list. And what I emphasize in the book is that this is a method book. It's not a diet book. It's not that I'm telling people, listen, folks, if you're going to eat these ingredients, you're going to be healthy and free of arthritis. Not at all. It's just an example of what can be done with a restricted ingredient list. Because my safe list and another person's safe list are different. And it happens that these ingredients that you mentioned are part of my safe list, but the book is based on my personal diet, but not restricted to it. So there are ingredients over there that actually I do not use in my personal diet. But it doesn't matter. What matters are the principles of alternative cooking, which are simplicity, of working actually with less ingredients than more.
Right. That's a great concept for readers. Now, could you talk a little about the gluten-free aspect? It looked like you have grains like polenta and wild rice. Why is the gluten-free diet important for those with inflammatory conditions?
What happened is that gluten a lot of time is associated with inflammation. And again, it can be for arthritis, it can be for celiac, it can be for other ailments. The main point is not necessarily the gluten-free aspect of it, but is the point of a self-study, meaning if a person knows that when he or she eats gluten and it causes inflammation, then it means that they have to avoid it. As simple as that. Now, in my case, I realized after a while that gluten is problematic for me, so I stopped using it, and as you said, I'm using corn, I'm using rice, I'm using wild rice sometimes. So this is why it appears on my diet. But again, I cannot overemphasize it. It's a personal issue. If gluten doesn't work for you, then use alternative ingredients.
Right, okay. Makes sense. Now, when I was flipping through this book, I was so struck by how creative and interesting some of these recipes were, like popcorn salad. Never would have thought of that. What are some of your favorite go-to recipes from this book?
Yes, the popcorn salad is always amuses me. And the reason I made it is, again, one of the principles of alternative cooking is that you make a maximum use of what you have. And the reason I added the popcorn is because of the texture, because it has a unique texture, and you know, I just wanted to make my food more varied, like to make it more interesting. So I said, hey, why not? And I did this combination of the popcorn salad, and people right away, you know, they notice it because it's an unusual use. But hey, why not? Right. Essentially, I mean, if it works and it works taste wise, then go ahead and use it. Another one, actually, the recipe that I'm most proud of is a light tortillas, and the reason I'm so proud of it is that I wanted to make a tortilla that is large and can be used as a wrap, and is relatively easy to make. And what happened with the light tortillas, it took me a while to get to the point of the right combination of liquids and solids, where the tortilla comes out really soft, and you can use it as a wrap, and also it's very easy to control the size of it because it's a liquid dough. And it took time to get to the right amount of liquids and solids. So that's the one I like. I also like, you'll be surprised, the recipes with the beef and fish and poultry, because they exemplify the simplicity of alternative cooking. Yeah. If you see there are two versions over there, I explain. One that use a base, which is essentially the fat that comes out of the meat, or you can use the meat without anything, even without the base. So, for instance, when I'm making tilapia, I just wrap it up in a foil, an aluminum foil. I put it in the oven, and this is it.
Right.
And it comes out wonderful. So it's just a matter of looking differently at food.
Yeah, it's a wonderful text, and the recipes are so accessible. Where can readers get this book?
Well, readers can get it, first of all, on my website, bakerdan.com, or they can always go to amazon.com, and within a month, this book will be available worldwide through the Amazon site in every country, and also the barnesandnobles.com, because Lightning Source, that belongs to Ingram, the biggest distributor in the world, took this book, so it's very, very good. So the book will be available anywhere.
Wonderful. Yeah. You've given us so much to think about in terms of alternative cooking. Thank you so much, Doctor. Thank you so much, Baker Dan.
It's doctor as well. It's true. It's a doctor under my formal name.
Oh, wonderful.
But I'm a doctor of education, so actually you were pretty correct.
Very good. Thank you again.